students, welcome to our offline class. At present, I am in 8th standard social study class. In the previous class, we already started a new concept in a political science part. In that, we already started the local government in the previous class. Now, we have to understand the objectives and functions of local government. This is the main important basic point we have to learn. Why? Because local government means it belongs to our panchayat raj system. So this is the main concept we have to learn about the panchayat raj system of Karnataka. So here, what are the main objectives of this local government? Here the very first one, to involve the local people in solving the problems of their own locality. It is very helpful to, this local government is very helpful to the involvement of the local people. The government head official of one officer is there, PDO. What is the meaning of PDO? What stands for here? Panchayat Development Officer. So he appointed by the government through the CET exam. That's why we have to understand he involved with the local people and he solved the problems of the locality. That is the main intention of this local government. The second one is that is to provide the knowledge of administration to common people. Already observed that recently you got Gram Panchayat elections. In that elections, so many uneducated fellows are participated in that at their own in that election, and they know about the very well administration of the locality. Why? Because they eagerly understand what are the facility we have to taken by the government. That is the main basic point we have to learn here. So the knowledge of administration to common people, that is the main intention of this local government. And the third one is there, the third main intention, to help the decentralizing power and make the administration more efficient. Decentralization power means it contains three kinds of panchayat. Which are the three kinds of panchayat? One is ZP, Jilla Panchayat, TP, Taluk Panchayat, then GP. GP means Gram Panchayat. In that, these three administration we have to consider as decentralization power. If the member of the Gram Panchayat, so he become an uneducated person, but he knows very well about the administration of this decentralization power. What are the facilities this Jilla Panchayat provide to Gram Panchayat? What kind of facility of the Taluk Panchayat provided to the Gram Panchayat? These are all the administration structure. He knows that. That's why it's a very important issue. The last point of the objective, that is to train or develop leadership qualities among people at the grassroots level. Grassroots level means up to basic platform. The basic platform, that means when he become a Gram Panchayat member, after the 5 years he knows everything administration of the Gram Panchayat. Then afterwards he participated in the election of Taluk Panchayat. Then he knows that after 5 years, then afterwards he participated in the Jilla Panchayat elections. So this is the step-by-step administration power. He knows that. That's why it's a very important thing. That's why the politicians call this one root, grassroot level. Okay. The next one is that the functions, important functions of local self-government. This local self-government, what are the functions it done here? The very first one, to maintain and protect the panchayat property. The very first point is very clear, that is to maintain and protect the panchayat property. It's a very essential part of the local body. The third function of the local government, that is to undertake health and family welfare programs. It is a very important point we have to understand here. To undertake health and family welfare programs, it implements. That is the main important thing we have to learn here. Then fourth one is to plan and undertake the development works like laying of roads, electrification, housing, supply of water, drinking water, and street lamps. So these are the facilities provided by the local government through the Gram Panchayat. The next one is that is to encourage, implement the primary, secondary and adult informal educational programs. So it takes the more care about educational to not only primary students, not only secondary students, not only adult students, entire these primary, secondary and adult children should take the informal education programs by the local government. This is the main factor we have to understand. Why? Because it's a major function of the local government. Dear students, you should know about that, because of it's a very essential part of your future life. That's why you have to understand this one. And to prevent all sorts of pollution and provide better, healthier facility, that is the most important thing we have to learn. And the next point is that to provide facilities for the distribution of essential commodities. Commodities means here the facility, what kind of facility we have to take from the local government, that is like food grains and kerosene, and locally we have to call that a ration. That ration also free supplied by the government. So it is also one of the main important function under the local government. So dear students, I hope to you understood this objectives and functions of the local government very well. In the next class we have to understand the major source income of the local government. Okay.